Name the most common fuel used in homes. So one fuel you have to, most common, which is used in home. What is it? Mohammed,
food oil. Food oil.
Food oil is not fuel. You are not burning food oil, right? Most common fuel is what?
Stove. Ma'am, gas cylinder.
Gas cylinder mein what is the fuel? LPG. Okay. So LPG, or you can say kerosene also. Nowadays it is LPG only. Liquefied petroleum gas. Okay.
And CNG so, is also there.
But CNG at home we don't use. Na? It is most common fuel used in homes. Okay. At home, which fuel you use? So that will be LPG. Okay. So just go through the question. Name the most common fire extinguisher. Most common
CO2,
fire extinguisher.
CO2.
That is carbon dioxide. But before that, you have a water fire extinguisher also. Okay.
Soda acid
also is there. So most common you can say water, because that is easily available. Only in case of electrical fire and oil-based fire, we don't use water extinguisher. What is the next question? What are the states in which a fuel may exist?
Liquid and gas.
Yeah, so all the three states, solid, liquid, and gaseous fuel. So all the three states, it exists. Name any two combustible substance. First of all, what is combustible substance?
A substance that burns and that goes through combustion.
That can burn in the air.
Yeah, that can burn in the presence of air, you have to say.
In the presence.
So, coal.
Yes, coal and?
Wood.
Okay. Any
two. Or any fuel, ma'am, kerosene or
kerosene, LPG. Yeah, any fuel, LPG, anything you can say. How are heat and light produced in the sun? We have discussed this. Anyone remembers? There is no combustion
with oxygen.
Oxygen is not there in sun. You know that there is.
Ma'am, nitrogen plus something, ma'am, it becomes oxygen.
Is not there. You just have to remember that nuclear reactions taking place in sun produces heat and light. Okay. Remember that there is no combustion taking place in sun. In sun, heat and light is produced due to nuclear reactions taking place over there. Now, nuclear reaction mein hydrogen and helium is there. So you don't go in that detail. But you should know sun ke andar the gases present is hydrogen, helium. Okay. Isotopes of hydrogen.
So ma'am, hydrogen plus helium makes up oxygen, na, ma'am?
No. It doesn't make oxygen. Where is oxygen in hydrogen and helium? Oxygen is an element and it is not present in the atmosphere. In space, oxygen is not present, right? That is why life is not there in space. Means you need to carry oxygen cylinder, right? Because oxygen is not there in space. Oxygen is there only in the atmosphere surrounding the Earth, right? So that is why we can survive. Life is not possible without oxygen. We have to make oxygen. Okay, previous question. How does a matchstick catch fire?
When you rub it against the box and it
chemical.
So you have to write completely. When the matchstick is rubbed against a rough surface, okay? So
friction takes place and it produces heat.
Heat due to which the ignition temperature of the matchstick is reached and it catches fire. So you have to mention complete answer. Okay. How it catches fire? Friction word aega. Friction produces heat because of which matchstick reaches the ignition temperature and catches fire. Yes.
Matchstick's ignition temperature is very low.
Yes. Because it is made up of that material. Okay. Whose ignition temperature is very low. So it reaches ignition temperature just by rubbing. So that answer is there. These questions I'm just discussing in class. Some questions I'll be giving you for homework. Why is sodium kept immersed? Okay, answer I wrote only. Why is sodium kept immersed in kerosene? Sodium cannot be stored in open air. Okay, it is kept immersed in kerosene. Anybody knows why it is kept immersed in kerosene? No? Because no, sodium is a very reactive metal, okay? Very reactive. So it can catch fire if it is kept in open. It has got very low ignition temperature that if you keep it at room temperature also, it will catch fire, okay? So that is why it has low ignition temperature. It will catch fire and that is why it is stored in kerosene, okay? It is kept in kerosene. What are inflammable substances?
Ma'am,
substances that catch
that do not catch fire, ma'am.
No, wrong. You're going wrong way. Inflammable means which catches fire easily and have very low ignition temperature. So the substances which have very low ignition temperature will catch fire easily. Okay? Inflammable means inka matlab opposite nahi hai, okay? So remember, inflammable means the substance which catches fire easily because they have very low ignition temperature. So example,
ma'am, can I say the example?
Yes.
Matchsticks and paper.
Paper, then kerosene, you can say, okay.
Petrol.
Petrol, yes. These are, now, explain how water gets boiled in paper cup without burning it. Who will explain this? Munir, can you explain this? How water gets boiled in paper cup without burning it? I showed you this activity.
Ma'am, can I tell? Ma'am, can I say?
The paper doesn't get burned up because of the water. The water is like the water does not let the fire to get to the paper. That is why the water gets
burned. There is a reason. Why water does not allow the burning of paper cup? There is a reason. One important line you have to mention. Anas, can you try that? Let's try. Why water gets boiled but paper does not burn? Rashta?
Ma'am, can I say?
Wait, I'll come back in the end. Those who know, I'll come and ask everyone, okay? Rashta, can you tell? We did this activity. I told you about this activity in the class. So, Muni was half correct. Who else can try?
Ma'am, can I say?
Only Abdullah? Rashta, are you there in the class?
Ma'am, is it because of some ignition temperature?
You have to mention ignition temperature. Okay. Yes, Abdullah, tell. What will be your answer? How water gets boiled in paper cup without burning it?
Ma'am, because the paper cup which is there and the water that is so the fire cannot burn the the paper cup because the water is helping is so the paper cup's ignition temperature is more than the ignition temperature of the other thing. That's why the fire, that's why it is not burning.
No, you cannot say that.
Water is not letting the fire
correct. Why water is not letting? See what is happening over here. Yeah, anyone else want to try? Amina, can you try?
And because water has less ignition temperature.
No, water has more ignition temperature than paper cup. But what happens that, see, I told you, when you take only a paper cup, it will burn very fast, whereas if you take paper cup filled with water, it will not burn. Only water will get boiled. Why it happens? Because that time, Abdullah, you told correct answer when I was showing you this activity. Why this happened? Because when you are burning, water filled cup, then the heat taken by the cup is transferred to water. Okay. So the cup is not taking the heat. I'll show you. Draw and what happens? This is cup, this is water, okay? You are giving heat, okay? When you are giving heat, heat reaches the cup first, okay? It gets heated up but it transfers heat to water. So the heat, it does not remain with this cup. So because of which, because of the conduction of heat to the water gets boiled up. Water gets boiled up, and because it is transferring its heat to water, it does not reach ignition temperature and it does not burn. Whereas if you take an empty cup, paper cup, and if you heat it, it will burn. Why it will burn? Because its ignition temperature normally is very low, and whatever heat is given to the paper cup, it will take the heat and reach the ignition temperature and it will burn. But if you fill water in it, what happens? It transfers its heat by conduction to water, and water is taking up all the heat. So no heat is remaining with this paper cup, and that is why it does not, although its ignition temperature is very low, but it does not reach that also. Whereas all the heat supplied to the paper cup is conducted to water. It reaches to water, and that is why water gets boiled. Is it clear? Is it clear, everyone? Muneeb, is it clear why water does not allow this pay? You are correct that water does not allow. Why it does not allow? Because the transfer of heat is taking place from the cup to the water. So water is taking up all the heat. It is getting heated up and boiled. Whereas the cup, the paper cup, does not reach its ignition temperature. And that is why it does not catch. It does not burn. Okay, so I have written answer also. I'll show you what answer, how to write this answer. If you want, you can write this answer. When we heat the paper cup containing water, heat is given to it. Heat given to it is rapidly transferred to water from the paper cup. The temperature of water goes on increasing until it attains its boiling point and starts boiling. And during this process, the heat is continuously being transferred to water. The paper cup does not attain its ignition temperature, and hence it does not burn. Okay. So the main two points you have to mention, that when you are heating water in a paper cup, then the heat transferred, heat from the paper cup is transferred to water, and the water starts boiling after some time by taking all the heat. And in this process, the paper cup does not attain its ignition temperature, and that is why it does not burn. So ignition temperature you have to mention, and the transfer of heat from paper cup to water. These are the two important points you have to mention in your answer. Is it clear, everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
So if I give you this answer, this question in the worksheet, please write down the answers. Okay. Okay. The questions which I would be giving you are these. Fill in the blanks. Burning of wood and coal causes dash of air. What of air?
Pollution.
Correct. Pollution of air. Liquid fuel used in homes is?
Combustible.
No. Any example you give. Kerosene, you can say. Okay? Fuel must be heated to its dash before it starts burning. Rashda. Fuel must be heated to its, yes, ignition temperature. The fire produced by oil cannot be controlled by?
Water extinguisher.
Water. Yes.
Water. Okay. Explain how the use of CNG in automobile has reduced pollution in our cities. Why CNG is the most ideal fuel? This question can be asked like that also, that why CNG is the most ideal fuel, or name the most ideal fuel. So you have to write the points, because unlike fossil fuel like coal and petroleum, CNG fuel does not pollute the air. It does not produce carbon dioxide or carbon monoxide. Okay? So that is advantageous. It is a cleaner fuel, and it does not produce the undesirable gases. Okay, like carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, which leads to respiratory diseases. Two important points, that it is a cleaner fuel and does not produce any unwanted gases which pollute the environment. Anas, you have to submit maths and science both worksheet, okay? You have to submit. Remember to submit it, okay? List conditions under which combustion can take place. So three conditions you have already written. What are the three
fire,
conditions?
Heat, fuel and oxygen.
Yeah, supporter of combustion. Okay, presence of fuel, supporter of combustion, which is oxygen, and then heat. Okay, which is therefore ignition temperature. To reach the ignition temperature, explain how use of same question as how has it has reduced. So it is same answer you will get. It is difficult to burn a heap of green leaves, but dry leaves catch fire easily. Muhammad Mohammadi,
ma'am,
give one answer. Muhammad Mohammadi,
ma'am, because the green leaves still have some little water on it, but the dry leaves are don't have water, so then the water stops the fire to burn, so that's why the dry leaves catch fire.
You have to mention in terms of ignition temperature, because of the presence of moisture on green leaves, the green leaves reaches ignition temperature very late, whereas dry leaves are dry and it can catch fire easily because it reaches ignition temperature by a small amount of heat only. Okay? Is it clear? So ignition temperature is because of the presence of water, it will take time to reach ignition temperature because water cools the substance, okay, lowers the temperature. So you have to mention lot of moisture. So ignition temperature is high and therefore does not catch fire easily, but less moisture, so it will catch fire easily, okay. So some of these questions I'll give you in worksheet. So that is why I'm discussing it, so that you write the answer properly. How CO2 is able to control fire? You have written it. This is in the point form. You have already written it.
Yes, ma'am. It is heavier than oxygen.
And it acts like a blanket. You have already written it in yesterday's class, okay? Last week's class. And it is kept in liquid form. So it is not a supporter of combustion. Give reason. Water is not used to control fires using electrical equipment. Why?
Because
it can electrocute.
Because it can electrocute the person who is helping in controlling fire. Okay. So because water is, you have to mention one more line. Water is a good conductor of electricity. So it will electrocute that person. LPG is better domestic fuel than wood. Why? Think about it. Why LPG?
Well, LPG has more ignition temperature than wood.
That is not a comparison. That is okay, fine. That will be there. But see, when wood burns, what gas is produced?
Carbon dioxide.
Is it helping the environment?
No.
No.
So LPG is a better domestic fuel than wood because it is much cleaner.
And because it is environment friendly and it is used in a lot of homes to cook food.
Correct. Okay. And it is, then one more point. From where do you obtain wood?
Trees.
From trees, and then trees are also used for
deforestation.
Yeah. Yes. Using wood promotes deforestation, which is very harmful for the environment, okay? Because trees only produce oxygen, which is required for sustainable life on earth, okay? So that is why 2-3 reasons you can put. These are just general question why LPG is better. So ek to pollution nahi karta hai, dusra wood, cutting of wood promotes deforestation, which is very harmful. Paper by itself catches fire, whereas a piece of paper wrapped around aluminium does not. So paper, it has low ignition temperature, that's why it catches fire, whereas paper wrapped around aluminium does not catch fire because the ignition temperature rises, okay? So that is why increase in ignition temperature does not catch fire easily. So you can write paper by itself catches fire, low ignition temperature, wrapped around aluminium does not catch fire because aluminium is good conductor of electricity, and by wrapping it around aluminium, it increases the ignition temperature. Main point is increase in ignition temperature. So there is transfer of heat from paper to aluminium pipes. Same reason that we did in water filled cup. Same reason. When you wrap aluminium with paper, the heat is transferred from paper to aluminium, and that is why it does not catch fire. Okay. When paper is wrapped around aluminium. Okay. So that is all. And
ma'am, you said that in this class you will start a new topic.
Ma'am, there are colors of extinguishers also, na? Black is CO2, then green mostly color is foam and all that.
Nowadays, different types of fire extinguishers are there. So, you should know how to, everyone, in every building you have fire extinguishers, like, right? So,
ma'am,
you
we don't have.
Yes, ma'am. But in our building, they give, in our building, they give it in the houses also.
Houses also, every floor also, you should know how to use it also.
I mean, our building is there on every floor.
I know how we use it, ma'am. That upper part, we pull it and we first we point the hose, and then the upper pin we pull it, then the foam comes out, or the any substance that is there.
When you pull that pin, now then I told you, now in soda acid also the chemical reaction takes place inside, and yes, carbon dioxide comes
out. It mixes and then it blasts off out of the hose.
So carbon dioxide comes out. So which is a good fire, acts as a fire extinguisher. Okay. So this we already did in the last class. I told you we would be using in separation of substances. Okay. Now, where do we need to separate substances? You know, all, first of all, what is matter? Earlier also I have discussed what is matter. What do you mean by matter? Tell me, Rashta, can you try? What is matter?
Weight.
Anything is matter.
Weight.
Something that has mass and volume.
Correct. Any object that has mass and volume. Okay? Mass means, mass and weight are two different things. So always say mass. Mass means when you weigh something, it will have some mass. Amount of matter contained in it. That is mass. Okay. So any object that has mass and it occupies space or it has volume is matter. Now, whatever you see around you is matter, and it can be anything, solid, liquid, gas. Okay. You have read that matter consists of three phase, solid, liquid, and gas. But whatever you see around you, do all substance exist in pure form or mixed form? If you see around yourself, if you see air, is it a pure thing or is it a mixed form?
Pure.
Air is pure, but air has got so many gases, right? Pure means air has got,
air comes from nature, right?
It comes from nature, but pure means any substance which consists of only one type of substance. Okay. For example, if I say pure oxygen, so oxygen will oxygen contain only oxygen, but mixture means when it consists of so many things mixed together physically. Mixture means things are mixed together physically. For example, last time also I was talking that when you go to a vegetable market and you put all the vegetables together, so that is a mixture, right? That will be a mixture. When you are mixing things physically, that is a mixture. But when a chemical reaction takes place, like when hydrogen and oxygen, they are mixed together chemically, then water is formed. Okay, and that water can be pure water. If you don't mix anything in water, it will be a pure water. Is it clear? So that water is pure substance, but when you mix something in water, it is a mixture. If you mix salt in it, if you make a lemon water, if you make lemon soda, so this will be a mixture. But when you take only water, pure water with no salts in it, it is called pure water or distilled water. Okay, so this is a difference between pure substances and mixed substances. Now, when you see around yourself, you will see most of the things are mixed only. There is very rarely you will get pure substances in nature. Rocks also, if
and
you
is
see.
Is water pure?
No, water that we drink is not pure. It has got minerals, it has got salts in it. Pure water you cannot drink. It will be tasteless. Pure water is used only in labs for experiments. Okay. So
pure water is harmful for us.
Yes, pure water is harmful for us. You need, your body needs salts and all, okay, minerals and salts. So that is why it is there in water and it should not be removed from water, drinking water. Okay. So, so what I was telling, that pure substances very rarely you get, but still you need pure substances for experiments, for separating. Why do we separate substance? So that to do some
experiments. And we can know the difference between pure and mixed.
Yes. Yeah. What did you ask, Amina? You? I didn't get you. What did you ask? Did you ask something?
No, I didn't ask. You said that why do we separate substances? So we separate it too.
So we why do we separate substances? Now coming to it, I'll just share. Wait. Wait, let me find out where is it. Okay, what is matter? Anything that has mass, solid, liquid, all things have gas. Now, matter can be divided, or substances can be divided into pure substances and impure or mixture. Okay, mixed substances. You can see over here, pure substances, they consist of same types of atom and molecules. So in pure substances, you have element and compound. Compound is made up of various element. When they are reacted chemically, then it is called as compound. Like water is a compound, but hydrogen, oxygen, they are elements. Okay, so element consists of same type of atoms, and compound consists of elements when they are reacted together in particular proportion or ratio, then they form compound. So elements and compounds, they are pure substances, whereas mixtures are, can be homogeneous and heterogeneous. Homogeneous when means different. Mixtures are when two substances or two or more substances are mixed physically. Physically means by stirring you are mixing, just haath se mix kar diya. So these are physical. So homogeneous and heterogeneous mixture means, heterogeneous mixture means when you mix two different size particles or matter substances, then it is heterogeneous. And homogeneous means same type. For example, salt when dissolved in water, you cannot see salt separately in water, right? When you dissolve salt in water or sugar in water, can you see salt or water present in the solution? Can you see?
No,
when it is dissolved completely. So it is a homogeneous mixture because salt gets completely mixed with water. And heterogeneous is like sand and water. When you mix sand and water, you will see that sand and water separately, means when the substance which do not, which are not soluble in the solvent, are heterogeneous mixtures. Okay. Is it clear? You can see sand and water separately. So it is a heterogeneous mixture. Okay. So for now, we just understand what are, now can, now see the flow chart over here. Matter can be differentiated into substances, means it should be pure substances, okay? Pure substances and mixtures. Pure substances can be further divided into elements and compounds. Now, elements cannot be broken down, and compounds are formed by the combination of two or more elements, okay? For example, water is made up of hydrogen and oxygen. And yahan pe iron, hydrogen, oxygen, the single elements will be the example of elements. Mixtures, now mixtures when more, one or more, two or more substances are present and mixed together physically. Physical is important, kyunki chemical mein compounds aa jate hain. So physically, so they can be divided into homogeneous and heterogeneous mixture. Okay, so just make this flow chart, matter likho, substances, mixtures. Substances further divided into elements and compounds, and mixture can be divided into homogeneous and heterogeneous mixture. Is it clear?
Ma'am, we have to write the information.
It's very confusing.
No, just remember matter may mixture and sub pure. Yes, you just write this thing. Don't write the whole part. Just write, make the flow chart like this.
Ma'am, it's very confusing.
Okay, I'll make it on whiteboard. Wait. Okay, first of all, you know what is matter, okay? I'm just making a flowchart. What is matter, you already know. Now, matter is divided into two types. Matter can be pure or mixture. So, pure substances. Matter can be divided into pure substances and it can be mixtures, okay? Now, pure substances pure substance can be element or compound. And mixtures can be homogeneous mixture and
hydrogen.
So example I'm writing, salt solution. I'll just write the examples, okay? Definition I'm not writing. Yeah, homogeneous
salt mixture for hydrogenous.
And sand water. What, Puni?
Ma'am, muddy water is also for
muddy water also you can write. Okay. Mixtures may many example any example mixture bahut kuch ho sakte hain. It can be rock is also a mixture of various rocks. Okay. Element may you can write single elements like hydrogen, oxygen, etc. Hydrogen, oxygen. OXY, GEN. Hydrogen, oxygen, compound mein, water, calcium, carbonate, any compound you can take, theek hai? Nitrogen, carbon dioxide, any compound, etc. Okay, so these are pure substances. Elements and compounds fall under pure substances and mixtures may homogeneous and heterogeneous. They are...
But in element, it is full one... But in compound, there is mixed now, so it will be a
mixed. There is mixed, but how they are mixed? They are mixed chemically. There is a chemical reaction between them. You cannot separate it, but physical jo mixture when you are doing, you can separate it. Yahan pe you have to separate chemically only. Another chemical decomposition will take place and then only you can separate. So this is your actually chemical mix. This you are mixing chemically or chemical reaction is taking place over here. Yahan pe no chemical reaction. Physically they are mixed. Is it okay? So physically yes, means like green grapes and black grapes are mixed. So that is a mixture. Okay. That is not compound. You cannot say it is not chemical reaction taking place over there. Okay, so compound is, although compound may you have many elements, but they are chemically reacted to make one compound, water. Okay, so hydrogen oxygen makes water. It is pure. Yeah.
So ma'am, like in what do we say, cake in the batter we mix so many things, so it is compound.
No,
because it is chemical.
But it is not chemical reaction over there, because there you have physical and chemical both things taking place. Okay, so you cannot, it is a mixture, but there you have chemical and physical both taking place and you cannot separate also. Okay, so you cannot say that it is a compound. It is not a compound. Always all chemical reaction will not make compound. Is it clear, Abdullah? all chemical reactions do not make compound. Okay, particular elements in fixed proportion will make like the reaction of water is what? H2 plus O2 gives 2H2O, and how do we balance it? Okay, so in this ratio only, if hydrogen and oxygen combine chemically, water will be formed. Okay, in this ratio only, hydrogen and other ratio, it will not make. So this is the fixed ratio. What is compound? When elements react with each other in a fixed ratio. Okay, so it is, then the compound is formed. All chemical reaction will not make compound. Okay, so is this flowchart clear to you all? Matter can be divided into pure substances and mixture. Pure substances can be made up of element and compounds, whereas mixtures can be homogeneous and heterogeneous. So, you can see over here also, element made up of same type of atoms, whereas compound may two different elements are chemically joined. So that is why you have two colors over here. Homogeneous mixture may you have, they mixed together uniformly. When there is a uniform mixture, they mix together uniformly. So you are not able to see salt and solution. Example I'm giving. And here you can see that when the two are not mixed uniformly, means non-uniform mixture is heterogeneous. Okay. So substance remains separated and do not have a composition throughout the mixture. You can see sand and water separately. So that is a heterogeneous mixture. And when you have salt and water together dissolved, you cannot see salt and water separately. So that is a homogeneous mixture, okay? But it is not a compound because they are not chemically reacting. This is just physical mix. You can see over here, this is a pure substance, banana. And when number of fruits mix together, it is a mixture, okay? So when you bring, and it can be easily separated. You can separate it by hand also, okay? You separate this grapes.
Mixture is when... Ma'am, a mixture is when different substances mix together or when the same substance mixes together.
Same substance mixture, it will not be a mixture, right? Different substances
If you mix same substances, ma'am, it will become compound.
Banana and banana. If you mix banana and banana, it is banana only. It is one type of substance.
And then it will be bigger also. Like if you mix one type of blocks, it will be bigger.
Quantity increases, but it is not a mixture. Okay. You should have minimum two or more substances. Then it is a mixture. You can see the example of other mixtures. Soda with ice, cold drinks, the salad, things are mixed together. Pizza, you have so many things mixed together. Then sandwiches also, it is a mixture. Chocolate chip cookies, it is a mixture.
You're making me hungry.
All food items. Huh? Okay, so two or more materials are this you can relate with. So I have given you these examples. Okay, not all of you had your breakfast, no? Then you'll not feel hungry. If you're not having breakfast, then you'll feel hungry. Or for pizza.
No, ma'am, I didn't.
Huh?
Ma'am, for pizza, anyone can get hungry.
Yes, ma'am. I can understand. For pizza, for sandwiches, cookies, and cold drinks, you can get hungry anytime. I know that. Okay, so basically these things are mixed physically, okay? And it can be separated. See, rock is again a mixture of different kind of rocks. Sandwich is mixture of bread, meat, tomato. Soda is mixture of what? Sugar, water, and gases are also present. Soda may you see bubbles. Whenever bubble is there, there is gas present in it. Okay. Lime juice, may mixture of lime, sugar, salt, and water. So it is a mixture. Okay, now coming to this. Now, can you give me examples of mixture? You know that three states of matter are there. Okay. So I'll stop sharing and we'll have a small discussion. Now we can have a mixture of solid-solid. You can have a mixture of solid-liquid. We can have a mixture of liquid-gas, solid-gas. Okay. So just give me first, I'm just naming the substances. You have to tell me the examples. Okay. Now give me a mixture of solid and liquid. One solid and one liquid, or two solid, one liquid, anything.
Water and ice.
Cement.
Okay, ma'am, ice.
Ma'am,
water and or solid.
But water and ice cannot be a mixture because water and ice are made up of same material.
Ma'am, water or water and sugar.
Correct. Water and sugar. Yes, water and salt. Ma'am. Who else? Yes, Muni.
Ma'am, sand and water.
Correct, sand and water, Humaina. Anas,
one ma'am, solid and one liquid.
Ma'am, sand is semi-liquid.
Ma'am, sugar cane and water.
Sand is solid. Sand is solid. Okay. Solid and liquid, I told, na? Example of a mixture of solid and liquid. So, salt, ma'am, water, sand, water, what else?
Sugar cane and ice.
Sugar cane.
Sugar cane and ice.
Ma'am, sugar cane juice comes, na? With that, they put ice.
Okay. But, you have to mention one liquid and one solid.
Ma'am, sugar cane juice, ma'am. Not sugar cane. But sugar cane juice and... Yes.
Ha, sugar cane juice and ice. Okay, fine.
Ma'am, strawberry and fresh cream.
Strawberry is solid and fresh cream is not liquid. Liquid cream you are taking. It is solid only.
Ma'am, it is liquid only, fresh.
Fresh cream is...
It's a little thick.
Fresh cream will come in which category? Solid, liquid or gas?
Liquid. It will not come in liquid. Liquid should be... See, viscosity of liquid is more, it becomes jelly-like material. Okay, viscosity means thick hota hai na. So that is, so it will not come in liquid. Okay?
Ma'am,
mein thin ma'am hona
then what will create
milk is liquid. Milk, ma'am, what do you use? Bornvita and milk?
Ma'am, horlicks
and ma'am, badam, pista wala doodh, ma'am. It is healthy. Haan. And there is badam and pista, which is... solid and do this liquid.
Correct. So that is also a solid and liquid.
Yeah, but cream will come in which category? We only
semi-solid. Semi-solid. Cream is semi-solid,
but it will come in solid. It will not be a liquid. Okay, milk is liquid.
Cream will come in solid.
Yes.
Okay. But it is so soft now.
Okay. Ah, it is soft, but it is soft solid. You can say soft solid. Okay. Okay, so done solid and liquid example. Next time we'll do more example. Liquid and gas example. Can anyone give me liquid and gas example? Mixture of liquid and gas.
Ma'am, petrol.
Which gas is there?
Ma'am, Coca-Cola. Ma'am, Coca-Cola.
Yes, Coca-Cola is correct.
Ma'am, I don't know which gas is in petrol, but I know there is one gas. I forgot
methane gas is there. Methane gas is there. Okay, so rest we'll discuss in the next class. I'll be sending you worksheets again on combustion today. Complete it by next week. Those who have not done the course, please complete it. Yeah. Bye, everyone.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.